Hi, I'm Dave from BMC. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use compliance job results to create an exception to a compliance rule, and then run the compliance job again to see how the exception affects job results. Compliance job results show how components satisfy or fail to satisfy compliance rules established in a component template. Sometimes it's useful to define a component as being an exception to a compliance rule. For this video, I know that a rule limiting the number of bad logons is not applicable because an upcoming security test will include repeated attempts to access certain servers. So, I want to define a temporary exception to the bad logon rule. This demo uses an existing compliance job. I'm assuming you already know how to set up compliance jobs. Another video demonstrates that process if you need some help there. So, let's take a look at compliance exceptions.
In the Jobs folder, navigate to a compliance job, right-click, and select Show Results. Open the results for a run and select Rules View. Here you see summary information about the number of rules that are found to be compliant, compliant with exceptions, non-compliant, and indeterminate. Notice how 726 rules are compliant and a whole bunch are non-compliant, 1,530 to be precise. Remember that number. Indeterminate, by the way, refers to situations where conditions cannot be classified as compliant or non-compliant, such as when the asset being tested in a compliance rule is undefined on a target server. Expand Rules View. I double-click on the tab to make this tab appear full screen. Expand this component template and scroll down and select the rule that is non-compliant. You can tell it's non-compliant because the text is in bold. I select Bad Logon Attempts. Over here, you see the number of target components that are compliant for that rule, compliant with exceptions, non-compliant, and indeterminate. There are 6 non-compliant components. I want to set an exception for this rule because I know we are performing some security tests, including one door-knocking function that attempts to repeatedly log onto servers. For the duration of this testing, the bad logon attempts rules are not applicable. To set an exception, select the rule, right-click, and select Set Exception. On this wizard, enter an identifying name. For reference number, you can optionally enter a number that can be used to synchronize this exception with some external system. For duration, specify that the exception either never expires or select expires and enter an expiration date and time. You can optionally enter notes. Click Next. The wizard shows the compliance rule for which you are setting up an exception. If you want to specify additional rules to which this exception applies, click here and select those rules. In this example, we're just making the one exception, so I won't be doing that. If you want to, you can use this panel to modify the rules used for this exception. You can select the rule and click Edit, then modify the rule using the rule editor. Again, in this example, we're just keeping it simple. So I click Next. The wizard lets you select the components to which an exception should apply. In this example, we're only looking at this one component, so those are already selected, so we don't have to do anything. So I click Finish. Now I return to the compliance job in the jobs folder. Right click the job and select execute. We can watch the job in the tasks in progress view. The job is finished now. Now I can expand that run of the job and select rules view. Here you can see there are still 726 compliant rules, but now there are 6 compliant with exceptions and 1524 non-compliant, 6 less than there used to be. I can expand rules view and expand the component. Scroll down to bad log on attempts, select the rule, and I can see that for each component we have compliant with exceptions. Congratulations, you've successfully defined an exception to a compliance rule. Rerun an existing compliance job and check the results, which now show one rule compliant with exceptions. You are now ready to learn more about the automation capabilities of BladeLogic Server Automation.